One doctor who wrote an op-ed disclosing that he has performed an illegal abortion in the state of Texas, now that abortions are illegal past 6 weeks, is fighting back and essentially saying, look, I did the illegal abortion, you're gonna sue me, come at me. Now, there's a strategy here that's actually really, really smart. But it turns out that he has in fact been sued, and the very people who have sued him are fascinating figures in and of themselves. So the plaintiff is the person, one of the people who has sued him is a plaintiff, a felon serving a federal sentence at home in Arkansas with no connection to the abortion at issue. The plaintiff said he filed the claim not because of strongly held views about reproductive rights, but in part because of the $10,000 that he could receive if the lawsuit is successful. Then there's the second lawsuit, just 4 paragraphs long, came from a man in Chicago who asked the state court to strike down the abortion law as invalid. So this is smart, right? Because in order for the law to be challenged, you need a lawsuit, you need a specific lawsuit. And here's a courageous doctor in the state of Texas who's like, I did an illegal abortion according to this ridiculous Texas law. And now there are 2 lawsuits filed against him, and this will work its way through the courts. That's the reason why, by the way, conservative groups that are trying to, you know, like threaten these doctors with lawsuits did not file a lawsuit against this doctor, because they know what the strategy is and they want to try to find ways to maintain this law or keep it implemented as the Department of Justice follows through with its lawsuit against the state of Texas and all of that. So Oscar Stiley, or Stilly, is one of the men who brought forward the lawsuit. That's the Arkansas guy. He said he decided to sue after reading a news report about Dr. Alan Braid's declaration. A former lawyer convicted of tax fraud in 2010 is sentenced to 15 years. And he said in an interview that he is not personally opposed to abortion, but thinks the measure should be subject to judicial review. In fact, he says, if the law is no good, why should we have to go through a long, drawn out process to find out if it's garbage, he said, after filing the complaint in state court in Bexar County, which includes San Antonio. And by the way, the Supreme Court is set to hear a different anti-abortion case, and this will really test the durability of Roe v. Wade. The Supreme Court has scheduled arguments for December 1st in a Mississippi case that tests Roe v. Wade, the 1973 Supreme Court decision guaranteeing the right to an abortion before viability, which is usually 22 to 24 weeks into pregnancy. So I'm gonna read a few excerpts from the op-ed that this doctor had written in the Washington Post in just a second. But Waz, I wanted to give you a chance to weigh in.
Yeah, I think it's telling that the sort of anti-abortion, pro-life, whatever the hell we're calling them these days, people are like, well, this guy is grandstanding. He doesn't wanna actually be sued. Nobody stand down, guys, don't sue him. Even though he's claiming that he performed an abortion that came after the 6 weeks, which may have been 7 or 8 weeks or what have you. I think that's very telling. And I think it's important that people understand that these anti-abortion people, they're not really anti-abortion. Sure, they might be anti-abortion just in the abstract, but really they're just, they want to control the sexual lives of others.
Yes.
They believe that sex should have consequences, quote unquote. They don't want to see sex for sport, everything, because otherwise they'd be like, look, we should, they'd be pushing stuff like sex education, access to contraception, access to birth control, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But they don't do that. Right, access to Plan B, you name it. They don't do that. They want to have control. They want to shame people for sex. They're actually some sick individuals, Anna, if you ask me.
Yeah.
But you know, I think it's a tell when you don't see it come hand in hand with other sort of solutions to avoiding unwanted pregnancies.
Yeah, that's a great point. This is about control. And for the lawmakers that champion this type of policy, it's about scoring brownie points with mm-hmm. the the base that is obsessed with controlling women and their sexual activity. And then finally, the Washington Post op-ed that was written by Alan Braid, that's the doctor who performed the abortion. He writes that in medical school in Texas, we'd been taught that abortion was an integral part of women's healthcare. When the Supreme Court issued its ruling in Roe v. Wade in 1973, recognizing abortion as a constitutional right, it enabled me to do the job I was trained to do. On the morning of September 6th, I provided an abortion to a woman who, though still in her first trimester, was beyond the state's new limit of 6 weeks. I acted because I had a duty of care to this patient, as I do for all patients, and because she has a fundamental right to receive this care. So I'm really proud to see that there are still some Americans who have a spine in this country, because that took guts. And now there is a specific lawsuit filed against him by two different people that will, you know, work its way through the courts. Clearly, there's precedent indicating that Texas's law is unconstitutional. And also, we live in a country that has a separation of church and state. No specific religion should dictate anyone's life. And so, I don't care about the religious arguments in favor of the abortion ban, and any other argument, including the argument that it's life from the moment of conception, is garbage. Especially when we're talking about, in this case, we're not even talking about fetuses, we're talking about embryos. Embryos, not viable outside of the woman's body. Zygotes, not viable outside of a woman's body. Fetuses, up to a certain point, not viable outside of a woman's body. A woman gets to make decisions about her own body. She is a living, breathing, independent life, and that's what matters here. Republicans, conservatives trying to control women's lives is not a good excuse for doing what Texas is doing here. So hopefully we get some justice in this case. We'll see.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks. Really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.